Well, the good news from the Commonwealth Games, India is on a roll. We're going to pretty good medals tally, and of course there are several days still to go, and we're going to do better and better. The entire country is firmly behind our sportspersons, and we are now asking, it's just again, have our sportspersons yet again proved that it's time for India to get together and focus on other sports, focus on all sports. It's great to be super and among the world's best, and one, two, of course, cricket is the first one that comes to mind, but that doesn't mean that we should neglect anymore. Is it about time to start? And like China, is it about time to start young? That's what we are looking at today. Joining me in the studio, Shagun Chowdhary, an Indian shooter, she's an Olympian and an Asian Games medalist as well. Shimon, Sharif, also a shooter, no name, is also joining us on the program. But before we get to hear from them, my colleague Sam Daniel has spoken to a couple of people in Chennai. Let's just listen in.
Good harvest for India in the Commonwealth Games, and with me two sports lovers, Santosh and Rohit. Thank you so much for your time. If you can begin with you, Rohit, how do you see this?
I think, we've done really well after such a long time in the Commonwealth Games. I think this has to be owed to the new academies that have been put up by various sportspersons and various gold medalists for India in various sports. To name a few, probably Gopi Chand's academy in Hyderabad, and Mary Kum has an academy of boxing, and Jagdish Singh has an academy for boxing and all that. So there's a lot of talent nourishment here in India, so I think that's showing right now. As well as all the domestic leagues, the ISL and Hockey India League and all that is nurturing a lot of young talent. Right. So I think these are the rewards for all these tournaments and the academies.
I think from the side of the government or the officials who are in the sports academy should actually find guys or youngsters who are interested in sports like this and not have proper sufficient just the background to just get into the sports like him and come up all the way. Instead of rewarding is very fine with the people, but then they can get more.
The government has given 50 lakhs.
I'm aware of the amount being rewarded to him, and as well as that they can encourage more people to get into this. Like they can help people from a little low category or like who are aware, who have the
identify their talent and groom them quite early, then rewarding after they win laurels.
Yeah, exactly. You can actually groom them, a lot of people who don't have the proper back support to bring them in and show their talents. Exactly.
You have any question for authorities?
Why are you not sending the proper people? I think they're not sending the people who are actually talented, and they're sending people who are either related to a big shot or something like that. So I think India has always had talent. There's never been a shortage of talent. Sending the right people has been a problem, because there'll be people who are winning medals at the Asia Games, but someone else might go for the Olympics and things like that. So this is what I want to know. So why are they doing that?
Shagun, let me start by asking you several interesting points there. One, when we loved dissecting this, what is causing this, this great spurt, and of course, we don't want to look a gift horse in the eye. We wanted to just keep going in the way that it is. But one of the points that the guest there made was that, it's because sportspersons are now getting involved in the game. He gave the example of Gopi Chand there. I'm sure you know a lot more, but just with one purpose, for the love of the game, and with targets, like next Olympics and next Asian Games, we're going to shine with X medals. How much of a role is that playing?
So that is making a huge impact. What the federation, especially in shooting, what they've done is that they have got a lot of our old veteran shooters to come into the coaching programs because they sort of understand the sport better and have been through the whole, been through competitions, been through the Olympics or whatever, and have a lot more knowledge to pass on to the junior lot. So starting at the grassroots level with the junior programs that they have started, especially with the National Rifle Association of India, they started a junior program where the juniors have got the same amount of funding as the seniors. And we have to understand that with juniors, Manu Bhakar is doing really well.
Mehuli Ghosh is 16,
right? Yeah, it's, so Mehuli Ghosh is doing very well is because they're picking them up young.
That's
and
it.
They are
Absolutely.
Investing in them.
And that's a great point, isn't it, Mon? Because, we keep talking, especially around the Olympics, you'll keep hearing us, when China is going to be topping charts or very close, we're going to keep saying, China starts picking up their sports person, identifying and investing in them as young as 5, 6, 7. And we wait till much, much later. So the point that I'm making, start them young, but are we sort of taking it with the seriousness it deserves?
Unfortunately not, because these are just few examples. These three teenagers in the Commonwealth Games team for India, Meuli Ghosh, and Manu Bhakar and Anish Bhanwale, they are just probably three or four teenagers in the Indian team right now. So I think we need to invest more in the infrastructure and make the sport more accessible to the masses. Then only we'll have a much larger pool.
I take the point, but you're saying that it's possible in all these disciplines to just, I mean, in a country our size, to just find a lot more talent. Has that been your experience as well?
Absolutely. You know, now look at Manu Bhakar's school in Jhajjar, Haryana. It's a small place, and they have a shooting range in the school. So I think if schools also play a very important role, if every school could, you know, develop an infrastructure for sports, I think that's an ideal ground where you can introduce more people to the sport.
It also has to be said that she came from there, and they, you know, and this is Haryana, but they, again, proving that they're women sportsperson. There's something about their sportspersons there, really. Well, before I hear from you, well, we've got a message from Nagendra this evening. Let's listen in.
Now, it is imperative that we as a nation recognize first and then glorify the participation in sports. Weightlifting in the past few days and today badminton have shown that how important it is to invest in sports that can spawn an altogether different sports economy. Our PM, who believes in business, should look at sports as, you know, as an economy that can bring hope, money and fame to millions of sportsmen who are left behind due to reasons ranging from financial, you know, inability, scarcity, to just taking that leap psychologically.
So take it more seriously. I mean, just see all that it can spawn. Shagun, come in here at this point. You know, often especially earlier, you know, when somebody got a sports ministry, I mean, it's, you know, it was not the most coveted ministry. And it was always thought that it's somewhere on the sidelines. But believe that there is now a lot more focus. We realize we need to do. I know what Mon is saying, that not enough. These are just a few examples. But to all those listening who say, what more can we do?
You know, we're on the right track. We are investing in our sports persons, with not just giving them just practice or whatever. We're investing a lot in sports science as well. There are a lot of private institutes that are, you know, so the making of an athlete is what people are understanding now, not just going and playing the game without, you know, being all over the place and not having the right direction.
Absolutely.
So I feel that sports persons who've gone through the whole, you know, who've been through the entire journey, have a lot more and are giving back to the sport as well. And that's what's really making a difference. If you see Gopinath, or if you see even in shooting with the coaches coming back and giving back to Jaswal Rana and all that. So you have to understand that they are using their experience in order to better the junior lot or the shooters that are going there. So that's all. So we need,
Shimon, I'm coming to just a bit, but we also got some views that my colleague Ratnadeep has got us this evening from Guwahati. We'll just listen in to what Guwahati feels about all this. Of course, remember Mirabai Chanu and Sanjita Chanu, both girls from Manipur there, and doing the entire country very proud in that region especially.
Well, everybody is excited with the gold rush for India at the CWG, and more so in the Northeast, where people love their sports. We are coming to you from Guwahati, and with me there are a bunch of youngsters who follow their sports. You know, at the CWG this time, India is witnessing a gold rush. How you youngsters see this? You people are excited about it.
Yes, very much we are excited. Basically, India is a blind follower of cricket, we can see. And cricket basically is a religion for all the youngsters in India. But for this year, this CWG, since the players are performing very well, we are excited about it very much. So basically, we can say that khelega India to bhi badega India.
Over the years, if you follow, Northeast has always excelled in sports. Even in the earlier years, without the infrastructure that was needed, Northeast players always excel. But these days, due to the infrastructure coming and with the thrust of the new government towards making Guwahati and Northeast a sports hub, we are getting a new infrastructure for not only for cricket or football, but for every other sport, maybe badminton, hockey or everything. With the infrastructure thrust that is coming in, I feel in the coming days, more and more sports person from the region will come, and not only two or three gold medals, but maybe 30 gold medals from India alone, from Northeast alone in CWG.
Well, that is very optimistic. One last thing. Now, in the coming 2 days, there are few more medal expectations. whom are you looking forward to?
First of all, I would like to congratulate Ms. Hina Das for coming into the semi-final just today morning. So congratulations to him. And as our Prime Minister told us that Assam, to create Assam as a sports hub. So as a Northeastern people, we are doing it. We are proving that, yeah, what Modi said, we are on the same path.
I'm just feeling so proud, you know, from that region. I'm coming to Shimon just because I'm told that we have a caller who's calling in with a comment this evening. Go ahead, Tanisha.
Yeah, hi. My question is that why are we only looking at the government for all the support? Why? What about more public participation or corporate philanthropy? What can we expect out of them?
Shimon, it's a fair point. I mean, how much do you want government to do? Why isn't this kind of, I mean, she called it sports philanthropy, interesting, but, you know, why aren't others doing more?
Yeah, certainly. See, if you talk about Olympic sports in India, they're totally dependent on the government. I think the sports federations have to take a call on this, and they need to market their sport well. And to market any sport, I think it needs to come on the television. So the sports ministry recently did a remarkable job by having the Khelo India school games telecasted on a major sports channel. I think that's the way forward. And I think if the sport is shown on the television and marketed well, packaged well, I think it'll do well.
Okay. You know, I want to speak a bit to you. You know, it's often said that, you know, the comparisons with cricket are very unfair. I mean, you know, we do love our cricket and we do very well in cricket. So, you know, people keep saying it's because, you know, you do so well, the country loves it. So the parallels are unfair. Would you agree? I mean, is it possible to love our cricket, focus on it, and not neglect everything else? Do you believe that's a possibility or not really?
Absolutely. If we have, see, cricket has been, we've started doing well in other sports now. If you see the rise of badminton or what happened today with table tennis or yesterday with table tennis, there are other sports that are coming into the limelight and are being highlighted through the games and especially through social media. So there's a lot more, like, people want to know about the athlete, where they come from. So like Shimon said, it's all about knowing the sport. Once more, once people know exactly where the sports persons are, there's a history behind it, there's some sort of, it's basically about knowing where the persons come from, where are they taking the country, and through what hurdles they've been. So if we kind of market that and give it enough visualization, I feel cricket and, I mean, the other sports will also do really well.